该找张老师。
Hi, I'm Destiny.
And I'm Sammy. And we're your hosts for tonight's performance.
We'd like to welcome you to Green Acres Youth Variety Show Fundraiser.
Tonight, we have a bunch of fun and unique acts for you.
We ask that you refrain from cell phone usage and enjoy the acts that we've brought for you tonight.
Donation buckets will be in the back and accepted at the end of our show. First up, we have Miss Lucy and her friend Daisy.
Enjoy the show.
Hi, my name is Lucy, and I'm Daisy. Today, Daisy is going to be answering questions, so may you please raise your hand, and Daisy will whisper in my ear, and I will call on you. The one with the black bow.
What's your favorite color?
It's teal. The one with the striped shirt.
Are you a boy or a girl, Shark?
I'm a girl, and my name is Daisy. The one with the glasses, that is my father.
What does Daisy like to eat?
Swedish fish and sardines. The one with the yellow shirt.
Has Daisy ever bitten anyone?
Of course I did. I think this might be the last question. I have not been counting. The one with the teal shirt.
What's your favorite color?
Teal, I think I already said that.
What's your favorite food?
Sardines.
What's your least favorite food?
Pasta.
Great job, Lucy and Daisy.
For our next act, we have Rachel performing Senza Sol Vienna by Wilbur Suit.
Seeds, sick belongings, and hostels and restaurant bins.
Roads are my home, the horizon's my target. If I keep on moving and never lose sight of it, treating my memory of you like a fire, let it burn out, don't fight it, and try to move on. It's been 60 weeks since I saw Vienna, a bandage and a wide smile's left across my face. I'll pick up my hiking boots when I am ready, and I'll put down my roots when I'm dead. The distance is futile. Come on, don't be hasty. You'll get that feeling deep inside your bones. And I'll be gone then when you must be alone.
Wow. That was just amazing, Rachel.
Hey, Destiny. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Interrupting cow.
Interrupting.
Moo! With some more jokes to come, we have Warner and his golf jokes.
I'm glad you're laughing now, because you may not be laughing when I finish with these one-liners. It's good to see everybody. No, I don't need a heckler. I'm trying to figure out why they asked me to participate in this. I guess it's because I'm one of the older members of the church, if not the oldest member. Not according to Judy, she's older than I am. But I've been coming to church here since the early 70s, and maybe that's why they asked me, I don't know. Plus, this is a fund, F-U-N-D, raiser for the youth, so let's not forget that as we leave the sanctuary tonight. Does everybody know how to play golf? Has everybody played golf? Have you been on a golf course? You watch golf a lot? A lot of my cards are out of order. Did you know that golf balls are like eggs? They're white, they're sold by the dozen, and a week later you have to buy more. It's amazing how a golfer who never helps around the house, Kevin, will replace his divots, repair his ball marks, and rake his sand trap. This one applies to Kevin also. When you stop to think about it, did you ever notice that it's a lot easier to get up at 6 a.m. to play golf than at 10 to mow the yard or come to church? Did you know that? The rake by the sand bunker is there for golfers who feel guilty about skipping out on lawn work. Everybody familiar with a scoring system in golf? You know, you have par four, you're supposed to shoot four, and then a par five, and a par three, and all that. If your opponent has trouble remembering whether he shot a six or a seven, he probably shot an eight. Golf appeals to the child in all of us, right, Suzanne? This is proven by our frequent inability to count past five. Are these getting any better as I go along? Judy says no. If profanity had any influence on the flight of a ball, most everyone would play better. golf is a perfect thing to do on Sunday because you always end up praying a lot. I play golf a lot with a boy named John St. George. And the other day we were walking along and I said, John, I'd move heaven and earth to break 100 on this course. And John says, try heaven, you've already moved most of the earth. Same guy I'm walking along with says, do you think it's a sin to play golf on Sunday? And John says, the way you play, it's a sin to play any time. Then a few final thoughts about aging. I thought growing old would take longer. I only have one thing on my bucket list, that's to keep breathing. Jamie and Beth know my computer skills. Just once, I want a username and password prompt to say close enough. Mark, never laugh at your spouse's choices. You are one of them. And last but not least, when you can't find the sunshine, be the sunshine.
Wow, that was really funny, Warner.
Next, we have Lily saying all 50 states in under 20 seconds.
Hi. All right, this is cool. Okay, so it's under 20 seconds. If you want to time it, you can time it. I don't care. Fastest I've gone is 14, though, so. Alabama, Alaska, Arizona, Arkansas, California, Colorado, Connecticut, Delaware, Florida, Georgia, Hawaii, Idaho, Illinois, Indiana, Iowa, Kansas, Kentucky, Louisiana, Maine, Maryland, Massachusetts, Michigan, Minnesota, Mississippi, Missouri, Montana, Nebraska, Nevada, New Hampshire, New Jersey, New Mexico, New York, North Carolina, North Dakota, Ohio, Oklahoma, Oregon, Pennsylvania, Rhode Island, South Carolina, South Dakota, Tennessee, Texas, Utah, Vermont, Virginia, Wisconsin, Wyoming.
Wow, guys. That was super impressive.
I don't think I could beat her record. Next up, we have Ella performing Can I Be Him by James Arthur.
Into the room, and now my heart's been stolen. You took me back in time to when I was unbroken. Now you're all I want, and I knew it from the very first moment. 'Cause the light came on when I heard that song, and I want you to sing it again. Thinking about won't you sing it again? Oh, when you sing it again, can I be him? Won't you sing it again? Oh, when you sing it again, can I be him? I swear that every word you sing, you're rolling for me. Like it was a private show, but I know you never saw me. Lights, come on, I'm on my own, will you be there? Could I be the one you talk about in all your stories? Can I be him? Can I be him? Can I be?
That was beautiful, Ella.
Coming to the stage now is Kayla Bricky with an awesome dance routine. That was just amazing, Caleb.
Next up, we have Marty performing Tiny Dancer by Elton John on the piano.
Thank you.
Thank you, Marty, for doing the short version of that song.
Hey, Sammy, why do seagulls fly over the sea?
I don't know. Why?
Because, you know, if they flew over the bay, they'd be bagels. Okay, I got another one. Okay, what's the difference between the bird flu and the swine flu?
I don't know.
Well, one requires tweetment and the other an ointment.
Very funny.
Next, we have A Spoken Word by Moselle for I Am a Christian by Maya Angelou.
When I say I'm a Christian, I'm not shouting I'm clean living. I'm whispering I was lost, now I'm found and forgiven. When I say I'm a Christian, I don't speak to this with pride. I'm confessing that I stumble and need Christ to be my guide. When I say I'm a Christian, I'm not trying to be strong. I'm professing that I'm weak and need His strength to carry on. When I say I'm a Christian, I'm not bragging of success. I'm admitting that I have failed and need God to clean my mess. When I say I'm a Christian, I'm not claiming to be perfect. My flaws are far too visible. But God thinks I'm worth it. When I say I'm a Christian, I still feel the sting of pain. I have my share of heartaches, so I call upon His name. When I say I'm a Christian, I'm not holier than thou. I'm just a simple sinner who received God's good grace. Somehow, God in you, God in me, to God be the glory. Amen.
Inspiring and touching.
Next up, we have Mike and Uncle Slane performing Lean on Me.
Uncle Slane? Let's kind of keep the same beat going, shall we?
Sometimes in our lives, we all have pain. We all have sorrow. But if we are wise, we understand always tomorrow. Lean on me when you're not strong. I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on. For it won't be long. I'm gonna need somebody to lean on. Lean on. Swallow your pride. If I have something you need to borrow, no one can fill your need. That you won't let show. You just call on me, brother, when you need a hand. We all need somebody, somebody to lean on, lean on. I just might have a problem that you understand. We all need somebody to lean on, somebody to lean on. Brother, when you're not strong, I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on. For it won't be long. I'll need a friend, somebody to lean on. So call on the brother if you need a hand. We all need somebody to lean on, I just might have a problem that you understand. We all need somebody to lean on. If there's a load you have to bear, you can't carry. I'm right up the road. I'll share your load, share your load, share your load. Lean on me, brother. When you're not strong, I'll be your friend. I'll help you to lean on. Just might have a problem that you understand. We all need somebody to lean on, to lean on.
What, Sammy?
An impasta.
Well, I know someone who can tell a joke better than Sammy. We have Jim next with some better jokes.
I don't know that I'm doing any better than Sammy, and the and that joke. Good morning. How are you all doing this evening? Or good afternoon. Or good evening. How are you all doing today? We'll get there eventually. Jamie kind of asked me to do this, kind of like Warner, and it was nice to do, but it was a little strange. She started out with, "Are you even listening to anything I'm saying?" which I thought was kind of a strange way to start a conversation, but that's okay. We're going to have a little competition. We're going to do this a little differently. Can I get four volunteers from the audience? Okay, come on up right here. Charlie, the prize is for adults, so can't really. Kip, come on up. Well, I mean, it's, yeah. Kip, come on up. I saw your hand up. Yep. Okay, and Deanna and the ladies from the later bit of the show, come on up. Deanna and Susan, yeah, come on up. We're having a good time. There we go. There we go. Now, here's the thing. We're going to see, it's going to be real easy for them not to laugh because these jokes aren't particularly funny because Jamie and Beth won't let me work in my natural kind of state in these kind of jokes. No. But that's okay. So here's the thing, and I need people in the audience to help us out because if they break, then they're out, okay? Then if you laugh, then you're out. And I picked up a couple of prizes. One is a Chick-fil-A gift card, and the other one is a Starbucks gift card. So, more fun for everybody. Okay? Huh? All right. So here we go. All right. How about those Canadians? Giving them in. How about those Canadians? Give them an inch, and they take 2.54 centimeters. Okay. I asked my Korean friend how things were going, or my North Korean friend how things were going over there. He said, "I can't complain." Okay. How do you tell the difference between a boy ant and a girl ant? How do you tell the gender of an ant? If you drop it in a glass of water and it floats, it's a boy ant. Oh, come on. Come on, those are funny. Okay. What do Alexander the Great and Winnie the Pooh have in common? Their middle name. Oh. Okay, she's gone. Bye, Jen. Now, one thing, while Jen's finding her way back to her seat, I'm actually stopping the practice of law. I'm actually going to open a shop where I sell pistols. I'm going to be a small arms dealer. Bye. Goodbye. I'm sorry. Forgive me about that.
You must face the audience.
Yes. You got to face the audience. Okay. What's Boba Fett's favorite paper towel? Bounty. Okay. What's a stormtrooper's favorite store? The one next to the Target. The Star Wars fans get that one. Both of them. Okay. What do you call a woman who's really good at darts? Amy. Amy. Okay. Now, Deanna was telling me earlier that, you know, her daughter doesn't think she gets enough privacy. At least that's what Deanna told me her diary said. Not really, Bennett, I'm just... Okay. Fun fact, Australia's biggest export is boomerangs. It's also their biggest import. Okay. Somebody better start laughing because I got two gift cards. Okay, I need better jokes. Okay. BB-8 is loved by parents. He's a good role model. Y'all know who BB-8 is, don't you? Yeah, the droid from Star Wars. How do you get a one-armed man out of a tree? Wave. Okay, I think they're gonna have to arm wrestle for the prize, because that's the best I got. Hold on, I might have a couple. No.
Oh. Why? They just stand there with the world revolving around them.
And how many Hokies does it take to screw in a light bulb? We'll find out in 4 to 6 years when they get electricity. All right. What did Batman say to Robin? what did Batman say to Robin before he got in the car? Robin, get in the car. What's that, Deanna? Are you laughing? Is it funny? Hey, Deanna, what's the least intelligent animal in the jungle? A polar bear. I hate Russian dolls. They're so full of themselves. My new thesaurus is terrible. It's also terrible. Why do you smear peanut butter on the road? To go with the traffic jam. Is that? Okay, gum. A communist joke isn't funny unless everybody gets it. What did the clock do when it was hungry? It went back 4 seconds. What's red and bad for your teeth? A brick. It really is. What? I know. What's the biggest enemy of caterpillars? Dogger pillars. What do you call a magician dog? A labracadabrador. I'm out. The rest of them are all like filthy. I can't tell them in church. I mean, they really are. Here you go.
Well, that sure was funny.
Next up, we have Andrea playing Maple Leaf Rag on the piano.
Thank you.
Wow, I wish I could play like that.
Me too. Well, we're not short of talent here, so next we bring Bennett playing Follow Your Arrow by Casey Musgraves.
If you say yourself for marriage, you're a bore. You don't save yourself for marriage, you're a horrible person. You won't have a drink, then you're a prude. But they'll call you a drunk soon as you down the first one. You can't lose the weight, then you're just fat. But if you lose too much, then you're on crack. Screwed if you do, and you're screwed if you don't. So you might as well do just whatever you want. Make lots of noise, kiss lots of boys, kiss lots of girls if that's something you're into. When the straight and narrow gets a little too straight, your sleeves. Follow your arrow wherever it points, yeah. Follow your arrow wherever it points. If you don't go to church, you go to hell. If you're first in the pew, then you're a self-righteous son of a screwed if you do, and you're screwed if you don't. So you might as well do just whatever you want. Make lots of noise, kiss lots of boys, or kiss lots of girls if that's something you're into. When the straight and narrow gets a little too straight, just roll up your sleeves. Follow your arrow wherever it points, yeah. Follow.
Way to go, Bennett.
Next, tapping her way to the stage is Cassidy, dancing to Know You Now by Amy Winehouse.
You're just a little boy.
Yeah.
Wow, did you hear those rhythms, Destiny?
I sure did. More musical performance will come with Mark and Mike playing Hey Jude on the trombone and piano.
All right, we're going to do our best Lennon and McCartney imitation, and when the time comes along, you'll know your part, right? And we may even have some leaders here. Your phones, they have lights on them, so you'll know when it comes down.
Thank you.
That was just great. I hope you all guys all enjoyed that.
Next, Sam is going to show us his unique trick.
So a lot of you probably grew up with this piece of cardboard right here, the Rubik's Cube. I got a bit of a smoother one that I'm gonna use today, but I just brought this for, I don't know, some reason. Anyway. I have my young Padawan here, who just happens to be older than me, timing me. But I'm gonna get someone from the audience to scramble this. Can I get a volunteer? Why doesn't a seagull fly over the bay? Because then it would be a bagel. I got one for Marty. Why did the skeleton play the piano in church? It had no organs. Yeah, and I think my cube is ready, so join me next time on Comedy with Sam. All right. Are you ready, sir? All right. 3, 2, 1, go. Yeah. Yes. This is hilarious. Oh, gosh. He threw me off. What is that sound? Minute 6. Eh. It's not my record.
That was fast. I sure wish I could do that.
I definitely can't. And closing out our show tonight is Donna and her crew performing Dancing Queen.
Thank you.
nice.
Wait, we have a surprise for our grand finale. We would like to invite all of the acts back up to the stage. For coming out on this beautiful Sunday evening.
Don't forget, our donated buckets are located back by the doors, and you can also donate online. The proceeds will help support our 2023 Montree Youth Trip.
We hope you enjoyed all the acts. Drive safe and have a great rest of your week.